Purity of the higher self. That's what providence is, this divine illumination of this absolute truth. It has nothing to do with temporal truth or egoic wants. So those are that type of meditation. And then there are moving meditations, which are about integrating, whether it's Tai Chi or Qigong, yoga, with the physical body. And all meditation ultimately will integrate the physical, the emotional, and the mental bodies. We will be starting our meditation with a centering. Some of you I know have been coming for many years and are familiar and seasoned with meditation. And some of you start before I even do the gong. And some of you will wait and rest into the centering, which is what allows us to let go of thoughts. And then we'll move into a place of space, of grace and stillness, and then we'll come out in a wave of prayer. Some meditation practices offer mudras that you might hold, and some meditation practices offer a position that you might be seated in, asana of a particular form. Here we say whatever works for you. If you have a mudra, if you have a way of sitting that is wonderful for you, all we ask is that you join in our common intention, is that all the channels and all the meridians of your physical, emotional, and mental bodies are wide open. And just by agreeing with that right now, we've done that. When the channels and meridians are open, you are able to relax, so we give it permission. And with that being said, the rest will be self-explanatory. The doors are gonna close. For those of you at home, you might wanna dim the lights. You might wanna draw the blinds, find that comfortable place, whatever feels right and good to you. A couple other intentions I'm gonna offer is that most people, the biggest observation of meditation that can be a little disturbing is when the surface mind chatters. Sometimes it chatters because there's things that I'm projecting into the future or things that have not settled from the past. And sometimes it comes from a disturbance, like a noise, clearing of a throat, a car driving by, or whatever that may be. I'm going to offer that we all say, nothing will disturb us. Nothing from the outside world, nothing from the inside world. Just perfect peace is what we will conform to. And then I'm also going to invite you to join me with the intention that this is going to be the best, most rejuvenating, most revitalizing, most revelatory, most relaxing, most deep and profound meditation ever. All right. We've prepared the cabin. We're ready for takeoff. I'm just going to invite. Thank you, sir. The lights. And we are now ready to begin. Begin by first giving ourselves permission to relax. Just saying to ourselves in our minds, I give myself permission to relax. As we invite, as we evoke, and as we allow the divine eternal energies of peace, love, tranquility, and beauty, wellness, and goodness to wash over us and to rise up from within us, knowing we have no place to go, we have nothing to do except completely surrender into the deepest state of relaxation, rejuvenation, and revelation. I invite you to bring your awareness to your crown at the top of your head and allow it to open. Imagine like the dome of an observatory that is open to gaze at the cosmos. That we open our crown to the highest illumination of the divine. And now I invite you to bring your awareness to your heart center, in the middle of your chest, where we allow our hearts to open, to blossom. Some feel tingles in the chest, or sometimes a little pressure. Some notice or see a beautiful orb of light, like an emerald green star, beginning to illuminate, becoming brighter. Some have seen or felt a beautiful lotus flower beginning to open. Outstretch its petals. Whatever you feel, whatever you see, whatever you sense, just allowing the heart to open to the higher heart. Now I invite you to bring your awareness to the highest point of divinity you can imagine. Imagine you're gazing up to a beautiful cosmic sky scattered with stars and planets that are shimmering and shining. One brilliant starburst of light is shining down a beam. Angelic waves of eternal grace, peace, and beauty are cascading over you and through you. As you look up, it's as though snowflakes of golden white light are wafting down, landing upon your scalp, shoulders, thighs. You notice effervescence of energy pouring down through your crown into your heart. The very heart of God merging with our heart. And as you breathe, becoming aware of your inhalation and your exhalation, it's as though you are fanning the flame, the internal, eternal light in the heart. And every cycle of breathing, the heart begins to grow in luminosity. Inhaling, you can feel a wave of energy come down through your crown into your heart. Exhaling, feel it rise from your heart, releasing from your crown. And as you inhale and exhale, you can feel the luminosity, the relaxation, flooding into every muscle of your physical body as we return to homeostasis. Relaxation and vitality. You begin to feel all the cells in your body illuminating from the inside out as this angelic light washes over us from the outside in. Cascading, glittering light flowing down softening and a strengthening. As that energy rises from your ankles into your knees, and from your knees to your hips. And we can feel our legs flooding with light, both in luminosity and weightlessness. All density is evaporating. And that light begins to swirl around in your hips, around your root, beneath your spine. And you can feel it opening, revitalizing and softening. You can feel that energy flowing through the intestines and kidneys up into your lower belly, lower back, rejuvenation and relaxation rising into your sacrum. The contagion of wellness as everything reverts back. That energy makes its way up into your upper belly and midsection, your middle back. You can feel your adrenals recalibrating, peace, ease. And that energy comes back to your heart, where your heart is beginning to grow even more. In love, beauty, and peace. And as that energy makes its way into your shoulder blades and shoulders, freedom, timelessness, and spaciousness begin to overwhelm them. You can feel the energy cascading down through your biceps, forearms, palms, fingers. And you feel that energy making its way into the throat center and the back of the neck, soothing, softening, strengthening. And we can feel it rising from your chin, your jawbone, your cheeks, your temples and brow, tingles down the bridge of the nose, as our face lets go of expression and returns to joy. You can feel that energy as your heart begins to expand, flowing from your physical into your emotional body. Waves of vitality, immense love, dynamic joy and peace, fortifying, amplifying, as the energy moves into your mental body. We let go of all thoughts, all to-dos, waves of clarity, open to providence, to illumination and inspiration. And you can feel your heart center expanding out from the mental body to the bliss body. Your entire auric field illuminated with the vibration of the higher heart. Pure, immense love. feel the energy of your soul. The energy of passion, peace, and oneness. Oneness with the Absolute. And it is here that we allow ourselves to go deeper and higher in communion with Spirit, the purity of love. Cycle of breathing, taking us deeper, rising us higher. Bring your awareness back to your heart center, allowing our breath and our breathing to continue to fan the internal and eternal flame. I invite you to join me with the intention of allowing our heart space to grow even more, to fortify, glorify, and amplify. As you take your next inhalation, imagine the energy of divine strength flooding your heart that allows us to be unwavering in passion, compassion, a love that surpasses human understanding. On your next inhalation, I invite you to imagine you're breathing in an awareness of self-love. Where you are able to see, know, and love yourself from a humble state of purity as the divine sees, knows, and loves you. Allow that self-love to show up as love of your body, love of your life, love of your being. Each of us agreeing that this pure, humble state of self-love shows up as a self-esteem, where we simply know ourselves as angels of the earth. We remember who we truly are. Inhaling that energy of self-love, divine strength, and allowing it to proliferate itself through your physical, emotional, and mental body. I invite you to imagine you're standing barefoot somewhere in nature, whether it is in your garden, a mountain, a forest, to feel on the most beautiful beach, wherever that heavenly oasis is. And I invite you to become aware of your 10th chakra at the south pole of your energy field, your earth star. And on your next inhalation, feel that energy of divine strength, self-love coming in from the very source and heart of your soul and God, through your heart, down through your central core to your earth star, nestled about a meter or so beneath the bottom of your feet. And as we ground heaven on earth through and as our being, as we take a moment in gratitude, knowing something wonderful is fortifying, amplifying, glorifying itself as our time. And the eternal is having its way. We recognize that there is an omniamorous intelligence, power, presence that is everywhere. In all dimensions of all incarnations, an unwavering love that is absolute. We take a moment as we open to the providential knowingness that where I am, God is, good is, the universal presence is. And that each and every one of us born from the holy heart, the holy mind of infinite glory has said, yes, I shall understand and live what it means to be in the world, but not of it. Healthfully, wealthfully, gloriously, peacefully, joyfully. Something wonderful. And as we come back into a lucid state of divine awareness, knowing where I am, infinite glory is, I allow myself to seek it, to find it. And we simply, in deep abiding thanksgiving for the light and the love to continue to grow and glow even more, even now, we simply allow it to be by saying, and so. Amen.
Amen.
Whenever you feel ready, if it happens already, open your eyes, or you're welcome to stay in the zone. The lights are going to come up in just a moment here at home. You're welcome to turn on your lights if you'd like to. Love streamers, and those of you who are here in person, we're going to take just a break for a few moments, about 3 minutes to be exact, and we will begin our music and the message. Happy Palm Sunday! welcome, and we continue to celebrate Ramadan and Women's History Month. We'll be back tomorrow.
Turn your cell phones off. And to get started, please turn to your program's page 2, and let's read Soul Center's declaration. There is one life, and that life is God. That life is perfect, and that life is my life now. I am here to receive the divine message for me. I am awake, I am tapped in, and I am transformed. And then you go like that. Today we have as our musical inspiration, Jimmy Etherton. And of course we have our gorgeous musicians, Brian Sherrick and Jessica DeWitt. Events and classes. If you've ever felt alone or have questions as a parent, join Reverend Michael Beckwith and Reverend Susie Lula for our first ever Inspired Parenting free online masterclass. In this inspired hour, you will find your parenting tribe, get your parenting questions answered, and learn from Reverend Michael and Rev Susie themselves about how raising their children in these teachings is the medicine for your parenting and child's soul. Newsflash, two special guests for the Inspired Masterclass with Revs Michael and Susie. Drum roll. We can practice that. Yes, it's Michaela Beckwith and Will Luca. They'll be joining us to share their perspectives as adults, having been raised in these teachings. Come and get the inside scoop on being raised in Inspired Parenting. Inspired Parenting Tools for a Thriving Family free masterclass will stream live on Zoom at agapelive.com, Wednesday, April 3rd, 6 p.m. Pacific. Replays made available for a limited time for missed live streams. The preview to this Inspired Parenting class is the preview to the upcoming 5-week course with Rev Susie of the same name begins on Wednesday, April 24th. This masterclass will stream live on Zoom at agapelive.com. Replays made available for a limited time for missed live streams. This will nourish your mind, body, spirit, and heart. Don't miss what promises to be a transformative, authentic, and memorable journey into parenting with greater awareness and inspiration. Register today at agapelive.com. Join Reverend Keith for this annual spring meditation and nature retreat in Ventura, California. This retreat will focus on an incredible journey in one of the most beautiful national parks in the country, Santa Cruz Island. With virtually no human inhabitants, being on Santa Cruz Island feels like you've gone back in time to a pristine and peaceful place, much like the Chumash natives experienced centuries ago. April 12th to the 13th, that's a Friday and Saturday. Register now at soulcenteroc.com. Just a few seats are left. I highly recommend it. Our very own community member, Diana Divine Light, right back in stand up. There she is. She's hosting a free in-person polar plunge gathering at her home in Irvine on Friday, April 5th from 5 to 9 p.m. There will be prayer, refreshments, music, and a polar plunge. This event has been approved by Soul Center. However, it is not being presented by Soul Center. For additional information, please pick up a flyer at our welcome table, and we'll see you there.
Yes.
For more information about Reverend Keith's daily affirmative prayer, Tuesdays A Course in Miracles, our Soul Circles, our weekly newsletter, and our last Sunday's Munch and Mingle, which is actually happening today for this month because next week is Easter, please see me if you haven't yet RSVP'd or sign up at the welcome table. Also, on other Sundays, Liz, lovely Liz, has organized casual lunches that we could join in on as well. let us connect you with volunteer opportunities. You too can be an announcer, or it improves your mental health, strengthens your community, and improves your social and leadership skills. Sign up with our fabulous volunteer leads, Colleen and Kathy, who are outside volunteering right now. And another tip, anything you buy at our Soul Center gift store, 12% goes to Soul Center. So let's go, Mike, make some purchases. And now, let's rock on.
Writing from the vantage point as the voice of God. My child, the sands of the ocean form a mighty bulwark, a wall, against the tide as it turns back unto itself. Yet the sands are made up of separate grains, small and seemingly insignificant. So do not feel that you as one soul are limited in your power to accomplish that which can be of great service to me and benefit to your fellow man. When you use the love that I have bestowed upon you, you will accomplish that which mighty armies are not able to achieve, as your work will be the work of spirit, and theirs is but a battling of the flesh, which would in time seek to destroy all spiritual things. But you must use this power in every way and daily. Pour forth your love to me first of all, and I shall teach you how to use it for the good of my children. I shall carry through you to the least of God's creatures. Wipe from your consciousness all the thoughts of revenge and all things unlike love. Fill your being so full of my loveliness that through you it shall spread to all you contact, making them in turn desire that which they feel in you. So shall my spirit pervade my universe through the individual exponents of my love. Let us turn within and pray. I'm just so grateful for that reading. The sand in the ocean metaphor reminds me of living here in Newport Beach and how beautiful it is here in California. And I'm equally grateful for every location on planet Earth, as they are all beautiful. I'm so grateful for Soul Center, where we can come together and connect to God. God is love. God is loveliness. God is peace, joy, and beauty. God is omniscient, omniactive, omnipotent, and omniamorous. So not only are we connected to God, we are one with God, always. So I bless today's service that it reminds us of that. I bless Reverend Keith. I bless the board. I bless the band, the volunteers, the prayer chaplains, and practitioners. I bless the Enlightened Kids Village, the audience, here in the room and watching online later. I bless our love streamers. And I bless you with a knowingness of your soul, your purpose, your authentic power, and that you will take that knowingness and shine your light throughout the week and forever. And it is with pure trust and faith that I release this prayer, knowing that it is done. And so it is. Amen. Now it's time for our Agape affirmations. You will find them in your program and coming up on the screen and the live stream. I'll speak a line and then we'll all repeat them together with sincerity and acceptance. Please rise. My life is a glorious celebration of God as me.
My life is a glorious celebration of God as me.
Today I am reborn in the awareness of my great and mighty destiny.
Today I am reborn in the awareness of my great and mighty destiny.
Miracles occur in the field of my inspired consciousness.
Miracles occur in the field of my inspired consciousness.
I am an angel for spiritual advancement on this planet.
I am an angel for spiritual advancement on this planet.
My acts of generosity quicken the flow of abundance in my life.
My acts of generosity quicken the flow of abundance in my life.
And in the spirit of gratitude, I live these words of truth.
In the spirit of gratitude, I live these words of truth.
And so it is.
And so it is.
Amen.
Amen.
those of you who would like to experience private individual prayer today, please come up here to the front by the gong, and you will be directed to a licensed Soul Center prayer chaplain or practitioner wearing the shawls, and we will pray with you on your behalf in a safe and confidential atmosphere. Thank you.
There.
Center.
Good morning.
Good morning, Love Live streamers. Let's all give the Love streamers a Tahina in Florida, we love you. Olive, I know you're there too. And Michelle in Australia. And those of you up in Northern California. Those of you in Massachusetts, we love you. Thank you for supporting our community. And we're just here to delve into a greater experience of self-love and love of the divine like never before. Is there anybody who's here at Soul Center for the very first time today? Oh, we're all seasoned. Is there anybody that's here for the first time that's just not singing, so? All right. If you're, we are gonna go ahead and we're gonna move on. I'm gonna invite you to remember the truth of why we come together. The reason we come together is to remember who you truly are. You are not your personality, you're not your gender, your race, your nationality. You are a divine emanation of the Most High. We are a Soul Center. We are part of the Agape International Spiritual Center, which means the new thought, ageless wisdom teachings that our forefathers and mothers for over 350 years have been practicing with a self-realized, divine, intentional experience of being in the world but not of the world, of understanding the laws that govern the universe and applying those as spiritual practice so that you can have a direct experience of your own magnificence. That's what we come here to do. We are here to celebrate that. Happy Palm Sunday. And also as we continue in Ramadan and as we continue in Women's History Month, there's always something to celebrate, something wonderful. And of course, in our teachings, we're gonna look for the highest capital T truth in all of that. Whether it is Easter, whether it is Passover, whether it is Ramadan, whether it is any of the other holidays, even St. Patrick's Day, as we had last week, we're going to find the spiritual significance that is back of this, because that is all there is. There is only one power, one light, one love, one intelligence, and one life, and it is God. And we are here to exploit that in the most humble and pure experience of the way. We continue in this month cultivating growth and gladness. We grow and expand in benevolent and beautiful ways, for we are here to have a beneficial presence and experience on the planet, and to be a beneficial presence and experience on this planet. And unless you are blissed out of your gourd in total nirvana with an awareness of the divine, even while you're sleeping through the night, where joy and service and kindness and goodness and generosity are just swirling and whirling through you every moment of every day, you wake up in the morning and go, oh, it is another day to just thrive in the divine. And you go to bed and say, ah, I'm going to move into the astral worlds of infinite glory and multi-dimensional awareness. If that is what you are experiencing, then you are probably pretty close to self-realized. If not, then you probably have some work to do. And that work is to play and pray. That is what we do. Now, sometimes, yes, there are moments in the human experience where we experience a challenge, where we experience something that is so consuming from the temporal world that it can seem like it might be insurmountable. But there is nothing that you will ever come across that is too big for God. For God Almighty indwells within us, and that is why it says in every spiritual, scriptural text around the globe, you are born in the image and likeness of God. And as I said a moment ago, that isn't your personality or your gender, your nationality, your race, or any of that. It is a divine spark. All of those other things are wonderful. Those are the costumes we came, the characters we're playing on planet Earth in this beautiful amusement park. That's what we came here to do. But not to lose sight of who we truly are. And as we move into the topic of today, which is immense love. Immense love, what's it gonna take? What's it gonna take for you to experience immense love? God's love is immense, which means it is great, it is enormous, it is big, it is intelligent. Make no mistake about it. Love, capital L love, and God are synonymous. God is omniamorous, all-loving, all-knowing, all-powerful, and omnipresent everywhere. There's no place you can go. You can run, but you can't hide from the divine. You can get out of a spaceship and go to Mars, and you're not going to escape the divine. The divine is in your spiritual DNA. And your spiritual DNA carries over into your physical, emotional, and mental DNA. So we are aligning with the divine design. And as you've heard me say before, we've agreed. We've all done a handshake. We've done the secret code handshake. You and I, you love streamers, and I, we are only healing, growing, and expanding in benevolent, dynamic, profound, efficient, immaculate, and glorious ways. We live in an intentional world until we no longer need to set intentions. We live in a world of free choice until we no longer need to choose, which means that if you use your free choice with free voice and allow your voice to amplify and speak the word of the divine, then you will begin to know what it means to be born in the image and likeness of God, and to anchor heaven on earth, to be in the world but not of the world. That's what we came here to do. We came here to know that we can either live fully in the immense energy and love of God, or we can restrict it. That's what free will does. You can restrict the flow of that life force energy, that love, or you can live it full out. Every one of us is gonna have to surrender to it. There's no choice there. That's the rub of the universe. You think you have free will and free choice, and you can try to resist as much as you want, but inevitably, the divine inertia, the same energy that right now is orbiting the Earth around the sun and the entire solar system, all of the planets that are orbiting around the sun, and the solar system is moving through the galaxy, and the galaxy is moving through the universe, that same energy that's doing all of that is pulling you into oneness as an experience. The paradox is you live in oneness because you have oneness in your spiritual DNA. You can't be separate from the divine. There's no such thing as a not spiritual person. Everybody's spiritual, not everybody knows that they're spiritual. So we want to make sure that we no longer hold back. If you are the vessel that allows love to flow through you and you don't hold it back, you will no longer harm yourself and you will no longer harm others. When you hold love back, it hurts. It hurts within our own selves and it can hurt other people. Sometimes it's so insignificant that we don't give it the time of day. But we're here to live unbridled love, which shows up is compassion. It shows up as kindness. It shows up as generosity and goodness. So it takes a little bit to understand the difference of what love is. Love is immense. God's love is immense. Human love, on the other hand, sometimes it's intense. It's intense because it's sometimes wrought with condition. It's sometimes wrought with erroneous definitions. Some people, you're not going to believe this, some people have love defined as hurt. They've been hurt or betrayed in a relationship, and then they think, as they stuff that away in their cellular memory and start to coagulate a definition, oh, I'd love to love, but it hurts, so I'm not going to love, and so I hold back. Everything in your trauma body that is going, it's going to come up for healing. There's no way to escape it. You have to allow the law of transmutation to heal every little nook and cranny, morsel and muscle of your beingness so that you can rise into your magnificence. You have to remember that the higher heart and higher love is associated with passion and self-love. And as a matter of fact, today, I am going to sell you on self-love. Seeing yourself as God sees you, knowing yourself as God knows you, loving yourself as God loves you. I'm going to invite you to allow self-love to overwhelm you, to look in the mirror and be able to see the divine looking back through your eyes at you. Self-love is one of the most underrated things on planet Earth. Most people, 90% of the population, if not more, are suffering from low self-esteem and some sort of self-deprivating thoughts and ideas. And, you know, there was a study, but it was done a while ago, that said, they said, there's absolutely no benefit in being your own worst critic. Most of us have been our own worst critic. And I can just verify, there wasn't actually a study on that, but it sounds like there have been studies, though, that I will get to in a moment, but there is no value in being your own worst critic. Being your own worst critic, some in the subconscious would think, well, that keeps me in line, or that, you know, it's kind of like the illusion of competition, where there's a competitive world, and we're going to compete, and competition breeds excellence. Excellence also breeds excellence. Love also begets love. So if we're going to move into the higher states of love, now this is where I'm going to burst another little bubble here. Most people associate love with romantic love. Romantic love is mostly 9 times, 9.5 times out of 10, lower love. Most times, romantic love is conditional. A lot of times romantic love carries a lot of baggage. And when you come into your spiritual awareness, you're gonna have to check your baggage at the door. We wanna move into the higher realm. So lower love is romantic love and compassion. Most people have to cultivate, like, oh, I gotta be compassionate, I gotta try, I gotta understand, I try to empathize with something that's going on, I gotta try. But there's a level of passion that can lift you in a state of compassion where there's no efforting. I remember years ago, I was like heaven bent on really applying. This is what we do. We apply these principles. Now, usually the way you do it is you take a principle, you take a holy idea, and you say, ah, I'm going to grab this idea and I'm going to apply it. I'm going to know that I and my brother and sister are one. There is no separation between me and you. There is oneness that we share. Oh, it is so tempting to believe that somebody else out there is an other. People who practice otherness. There is no otherness. We are in oneness. And as soon as we can understand that every single person in your life, even that dirty bird that is just, you think, oh God, no, that's not me. That is a mirror reflecting to you. Could be a tiny little aspect of you. I shared this years ago. I went to Whole Foods, to the supermarket, and I was buying some things, and I came back out to my car, and when I got in my car, I opened my door, the brand new, beautiful black Mercedes that was sitting right next to me. It was so close that when I opened my door, it kind of went bonk, and you could hear the little bonk. And I looked, and there was this teeny tiny, about 1 millimeter of white from my white car onto the black car, and I was like, it didn't come off. But anyway, I closed the door, and I was getting ready to move and pull out, and then all of a sudden, bum, 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 this guy was pounding on my window that startled me. And when you get startled, oftentimes a fight or flight response starts. Oh my God, I'm being attacked. What's going on? So that fight or flight response started within me. And this man was just enraged. He was yelling and screaming, you are such an ASS. I can't believe you. How much you are irresponsible. La, 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 la. Your door hit my car. And he's yelling and screaming at me. And I'm just like, trying to take it all in because it was like there was nothing. And so right then and there, I just stopped and I prayed. He didn't see it, I kept my eyes open, but in my mind, I could see how there was like, and I'm sending up a prayer, and I'm like, let me be an instrument of thy peace, of thy love, of thy good. And I could feel the energy starting to come over me. And he's yelling all these things, and it's very accusatory. It was very accusatory. And so, and I was thinking, there was a part of me that was like, oh yeah, well, you're wrong. But I did not go there. I surrendered to my higher self, and it took a minute to get there. And a minute was actually, it seemed like a few minutes, but it was really about 5 seconds. And you know how that time thing happens when you're, all of a sudden, it's like 1 second. Well, it's in that zone. And anyway, all of a sudden, I became aware of this little boy who had not been heard, who had not been seen, who had been taken advantage of, who had not been listened to. And I was like, whoa. And then another thing was a gobsmack that came over me, was the things he was accusing me of at that particular moment were not true, but they were true in my life at other times. And I had to look at myself as those words that he was saying against me. And it was very humbling. And I was like, oh, and I had to digest that. And I recalled that several days before I was said, I want to be that instrument of thy peace, of thy love, of thy compassion. And so as he was, and then all of a sudden with those two revelations coming in, I dropped into the deepest state of compassion. And I just looked at him and I said, I am so sorry. You are absolutely right. And he just went, okay. He didn't know what to do with himself. And I said, I'm really sorry. I absolutely pray that you feel my sincerity. And he said, I absolutely do. He got in his car and he was kind of like, and then I drove away feeling like, oh my God, empowerment and healing. Healing is going to humble you. Because when you think you're right about something, you're gonna need to be humbled. Mm. And to be humbled is one of the greatest gifts you will ever give yourself. Because there are times when we go through life and we think we're right about, yes, I was right. And there was a few people that were watching. And if I had polled everybody and said, do you think that this was disproportionate to what was going on? They would, oh yeah, he was a loony bird. But God doesn't look at anybody as a loony bird. God does not sit there and go, well, yeah, you kind of messed up. You've got some issues. Yeah, take a look at that. To be the angel of the earth for someone when they need it, is to be the presence of God and to be a beneficial presence on the planet. That means you can't go with the rote 60,000 to 70,000 thoughts a day that 90% of them you repeat in your mind over and over. You're repeating whether they're deprecating or whether they're falsely affirming. Falsely affirming is like, oh, I look good today, you know, whatever. But to be in a humble state of holy awareness, and then the next time, and then all of a sudden, as you know, as I started this whole life transformation 23 years ago, as I went into practitioner training and we started to have to, you know, look at the idea of counseling people spiritually. And so I went on this retreat after I had graduated from practitioner training, which, you know, is 4 years of, you know, work and catharsis and also opening up to the highest levels of compassion. And all of a sudden, I go on this retreat, and I'm thinking, it's for me, I'm going to grow on, ugh. And this woman gloms on to me. She was the most needy, the most desperate, the most, had so many issues. And all I wanted to do was run for the hills. I was like, you have got to be kidding me. She had issues and ended up, she has been one of my best clients that I've had for the past 10 or so years. And I had to go deep and see, what am I not seeing? What about my neediness do I need to check into? The universe is very efficient. Whatever you need to see, whatever you need to know, sometimes it seems malevolently, and mostly that's why I have the preamble of benevolent healing and growth. But as I was actually one of the first people in her entire life to listen to her, to understand. Her family had written her off as kind of a nut. Friends kind of, they would take so much of what she had to offer, and then they would eventually bail. And she had this trail of people who just left her and left her and left her. And so as I said, you know what, I won't be that person. I am not. I will be the one that is going to be there. I'm going to go deeper and higher and hear what you have to say and become aware of what you're really looking for. And we started to do the work. And today she's thriving. She has friendships that are real. She gets heard, she gets seen, she gets loved. So I'm going to implore you to go into the deepest states of self-love, lower love, which contains judgment. That is that sometimes associated with that whole romantic thing. You really don't really understand when you think of romantic love, what your definition of romantic love may be. Some people's definition of romantic love is you complete
me.
Some people, the romantic love is, oh, you're going to save me. And that's not, you have to be in love with you. And then overflow from that, which means you're going to have a self-love, a self-esteem, a confidence. You're going to know that God is your source and your supply. And when you move into higher love is when you feel passionate for life. There's things you want to do. There's things that you're going to create. The energy, the law of creation is flowing through you, and you feel passion, and that is love. That is love. Love is the one power back of all life. And as you move into self-love, you're going to feel that passion, and you're also going to move into a praising nature, where you're going to become in love with life, which means you're in love with the divine as you. When you can move into the higher forms of love and let go of those limiting ideas of lower love, which is that romantic and sometimes erroneously conceived compassion, lowercase d compassion, and move into passion and move into praise, where you can like, ah, you see the serendipitous things, and again, moving into a place where you can say and understand what it says in Scripture, to love thy Lord God with all your heart, with all your soul, and with all your mind. That is what we want to do, is surrender to that, capitulate to that, open to that. Easier said than done. We want to make sure that all you do be done from love. We've all seen the bumper sticker, what would Jesus do? He would love. What would God do? Love. What would love do? Love. We're going to love. We're going to allow love to be the power, that omni-amorous energy within us. And if you don't love yourself, you will get precisely back to you. People will love you in direct correlation to the way you love yourself. Now, we all have ebbs and flows. You have your good days where you're like, yeah, I'm all right. I'm feeling good. And you're going to find as you turn to this section of the mirror, oh, reflections of people who are reflecting back, my goodness. Oh, these are the people I'm going to hang around with. Then as you turn over here to the other part of the mirror, on those low days, you're going to find reflections of people that seem needy or they have self-esteem issues, and you're going to want to have nothing to do with them. At the very least, you're going to say, I will turn within and I will understand what I need to know to bring forward, because as you rise, all rise. We are rising together. As you move into self-esteem and self-love, you will understand what it says in Proverbs when it says, give me your heart and let your eyes observe my ways. When you give your heart to the divine, which is synonymous with yourself, your higher self, and let your eyes interpret it, I like what it says in A Course in Miracles, where it says, do not make the mistake of thinking you understand for what you see. For when you allow the Holy Spirit to interpret what you see, then you will understand. That means you are removing the filter of temporal observation, and you're allowing yourself to move into the higher states of consciousness, the higher mind, the higher heart, not the lower heart where betrayal and pain is, the higher heart that has been unmoved and unwavered. So I'm going to invite you to join me right now. We're all going to do a declaration. I'm just going to invite you to repeat after me. I am allowing myself.
I am allowing myself.
To see myself as God sees me.
To see myself as God sees me.
I am allowing myself.
I am allowing myself.
To know myself as God knows me.
To know myself as God knows me.
And I am allowing myself.
And I am allowing myself.
To love myself as God loves me.
To love myself as God loves me.
All right, now, I think I could hear you guys louder on the left screen than here. That was above 50%, so that's good. Oh. Okay, not everybody, but some of you a little more than others, but I want, that's your growth work, to be able to say that and really, truly allow it. As I was having a conversation with somebody right before service began about allowing. You must allow the divine to flow through you. That's why the prayer of Saint Francis says, use me as an instrument of thy peace. Use me as an instrument of love, because you have to give permission. You have to allow it to be. So when you say, I am allowing myself to experience and know that how God sees and loves and knows me, then you are giving yourself permission to open to a new perception, a new paradigm. We've all made the agreement, and you're going to let that snowball and rise up from within you into a greater experience of nirvana. You know, there was a study that, this is a real study, that was done a while back, where people with self-esteem, they're always trying to placate themselves through things of the outside world. And so some people for self-esteem, and I used to do this when I was in middle school and high school, the way I did it was, I was gonna dress the coolest, because if I dress cool, all people are gonna think I'm cool. I'm gonna get the hippest clothes, I had the top siders, and I had the, you know, all the, back in the day. People were like, what are top siders? They were really hip shoes back in the day. So that's the way, but some people, it's like, oh, if I look good, and diet, and exercise, and weight loss, and things of that nature, but not addressing what's inside. If you address what's inside about self-esteem, you won't need those other things to control or manage. They'll just happen. You'll just find yourself out exercising and doing stuff without even thinking about it. But when I go backwards, when I flip the tables, and I'm like, I've got to exercise. Oh, I've got to lose a couple of LBs. I got to really check my diet because, you know, I'm not eating enough superfoods these days. I've been eating some comfort food. We want to make sure that we flip the tables and we come to a place where it's like self-love comes first. The habits will follow. We want to move into a space where we address. Remember the old formula from last year? Assess, address, bless. You assess what's going on, you address what's going on, self-love and self-esteem, and you bless what's going on by inviting, evoking, and allowing that good to happen to, through, and as your life. We're going to do that right now as we move into the prayer field, and I'm going to invite you to join me. You're going to let this week a demonstration where you are so filled with self-love and self-esteem that you're going to see yourself and know yourself and love yourself as God knows, loves, and sees you, that you're just going to be like, whoo, whoo. And it's going to be different. It's going to be different. It's not egoic. It's not boastful. Some people are going to have tears that come up. Some people will have tears of joy that come up. Some people will just feel like, ah. But you're going to let that in. And that means the power of redemption might have to forgive something, like I forgave myself for being what I was accused of being by that gentleman. And I was like, ooh, okay. Didn't see that one coming. All right, we're gonna move into the prayer field. I'm gonna invite you to join me as we tune and turn within right here, right now. Oh, how good it is to know that there is a loving presence that is so immense and intense. And we have said yes to God's intensity, to God's immensity. We open our hearts, our bodies, our emotions, our minds, and we say yes. I remember the truth. There is one power, one omniamorous life back of everything that is seeking to know itself as me, as my life. I am the beloved in whom God is so pleased, and I'm choosing to know what that looks like, feels like, smells like, tastes like, sounds like, experiences like in its purest, most humble form. Right here, right now, we remember the truth of what it means to be born in the image and likeness of God, knowing that God is all loving beyond our wildest dreams of goodness, all giving, never withholding. There has never been a moment, never been an instance where the universe has ever withheld anything. Not time, not money, not resources, not love. It is abundant, and it is ours for the taking as we allow ourselves to forsake the temporal world, which means let go of temporal ideas and open to the divine providential awareness that wherever I am, the entirety of the kingdom of heaven is. Oh, this is the real truth, the real reality, the one power, the one presence that is alive in you. We allow it to rise up from within us and shine itself, know itself, and love everything and everyone. We allow that love to be so profound and so deep and so contagious that we feel and know and understand what it means to be a beneficial presence on this planet and to receive the benefits back. We invest in the divine, and the divine has invested in us, and we allow it to grow and glow. We simply say, yes, I know myself, see myself, love myself as God knows, loves, and sees me, and I am allowing it to be now. I'm allowing it to be retroactive. I am allowing forgiveness and redemption and purification wherever it is necessary. No self-deprecation in my life, only self-appreciation in the most humble and pure ways. We allow it to be good, we allow it to be now, we allow it to be so, and we do so by saying, and so I let it be.
So I let it be.
And so it is.
And so it is.
Amen.
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 Amen. It's our conscious time of investing in the divine, investing in our community, circulation. The law of circulation is what we are doing. And the ushers are going to come forward. They're going to start to circulate the baskets where you can give in a variety of ways. There's information coming up on the screen. There's a QR code you can use if you want to use that to take you right to donating online. You can also text the word GIVE to area code 669-342-2157. All the information is coming up on the screens for you at home, love streamers, including our address where you can mail the old-fashioned paper checks if you want to do so. We appreciate you, and we are now ready for
music.
Yes, Jimmy.
Orale, Jimmy.
So I'm sure if you guys are aware of all of your founder's talents, but this is yet another. Her first foray into songwriting was with me and Jesse. We wrote this, I think it was pre Soul Center. I mean, she was writing a song for the Soul Center. And so after many different revisions, this is Jessica's song. I mean, lyrically, she wrote this song, so it is, you know, very indicative of the message that is conveyed here every week. So, nice work, Jessica.
Yeah.
The original kings, not the first.
the ushers have come forward and we're going to bless the offering. Those of you who don't, invite you to join me as we bless the offering, which means we're going to extend our heart, our prayers through our hands. Oh, we take a moment of deep gratitude. Grateful to know there is one power, one presence, one supply of all good, and that is God. God is life. God is life, omniactively flowing and glowing itself, and the source and supply of all good all the time, never withholding, only lavishing, loving, praising, and raising. That is the nature of God, that is the nature of life, that is the nature of our infinite eternal beingness. I am grateful for this offering, knowing that as we continue to grow here at Soul Center, we are simply saying yes to being a beneficial presence on the planet. All needs met, all programs fulfilled and satiated. Our children's programs, our practitioners and prayer chaplain programs, classes and our building, all needs met. And as we rise, all rise. And we know that this is not just for our community, it is us individually and collectively. And as this offering has come forward, we know that it returns multiplied minimally 10 times to all of those who are circulating in the energy of circulation. We allow it to be good, we bless it as good, we continue to grow, glow, and expand from glory to greater glory, and we simply say, and so it is.
So it is.
Amen.
Amen.
All right, Soul Center. I'm just gonna invite you to practitioners, prayer chaplains, if you could rise up for just one moment. These are the individuals that are gonna be right up here by the gong. If you would like to experience personal, confidential, powerful, and magnificent prayer just for you, you'll hook up with one of them. They'll take you to a place where you can experience that. Thank you, practitioners and prayer chaplains. And now we're ready for the
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
My name is Jessica, and I was with the Enlightened Kids Village program this morning, and we had the special privilege. Let's put on down, guys. Of having a bunch of Boy Scouts here today from Irvine Troop 695. Oh, they were extremely helpful in setting up, and they also participated, and there's a few cleaning up right now, so we were so blessed to have them come and help. And so today, with manifestation, it's kind of the theme of the month, and we were talking about the power of your thoughts and energy when you're trying to manifest your dreams. And how our thoughts have a powerful energy. The craft that we did called the crystal. Does anybody have their crystal?
Yeah.
And we put what we want to manifest on the crystal, and then we decorated the crystal, knowing that this is a tangible tool for the children to connect and manifest with a vibrational alignment needed for successful manifestation. And then we made our manifestation mandalas. Anybody want to show their mandala? Okay.
Yeah.
And they put their let those that want to share about theirs in a second. But our activity that we did while we were learning about the positive mental attitude and energy that we need to align with in order to make our dreams come true. This side we started out with some negative self-talk that we might sometimes tell ourselves. And some of the things that the kids said, Akorn, you wanna tell us, what are some of the negative self-talk things that we said?
She asked us to suggest some negative thoughts that we might be feeling. Some of the ideas that came up were, I'm sad, or I'm tired, or I can't do this, I'm not good enough, that kind of thing.
You wanna say what,
yeah. So then she asked us to jump as high as we could while everyone and they themselves were saying these negative thoughts.
And so,
and as you can see, we didn't get very high.
And then we
switched. Look where I ended up.
Awkward was way down there. And then what did we do?
And then we started saying all positive thoughts. Then we improved quite a bit.
What are some of the positive things?
So the positive things were, this is easy, life's good, I'm amazing, I'm one of a kind, I can do this.
Yeah! So We have a few that improved by like 4 or 5. Look, here's Hector, and then Hector went like off the paper. So we had a lot of fun with this activity. And then does anybody want to share what they wanted on their mandala? Okay.
So I'm writing a book called Seven Angels, and then so I put I am talented.
I am flexible.
I put I want to be successful in the future.
Yeah. Rise and sing our peace song. Thank you so much.
The words are coming up on the screen or they're in the program if you'd like to sing along. Throughout the rest of this day, this week, this month, this year, we let it be good and we let it be so. And